You're listening to Haze Radio Network, Cannabis Lifestyle Radio.
What's good, y'all? You know who it is, your boy, Jaden Kiss. Right now with Cali Tree Boy, you heard? This joint right here is called 20 Blunts. Shout out to California.
Yeah.
Shout out to Water Life Music.
We done smoked about 20 blunts. Swishing sweets in the cut. Yeah. I'm rolling up. I've been high ever since I woke up. I love to find a reason just to toke up. We done smoked about 20 blunts. Swishing sweets in the cut. Yeah. I'm rolling up. I've been high ever since I woke up. I love to find a reason just to toke up.
Look, yo, yo, yo.
Little kid, Mary Jane has been my close friend. Tried to break us up,
but they didn't win.
It feels like a good sin.
What's up, Cali Tree Boy?
My close kid.
Is our shit
like
only?
Oxygen. Yeah. Pop rocks.
Haze Radio.
I also keep an OG, bro, just in case.
I got you, bro.
Cake turned into the new cookie.
Rolling up, bro.
Purple
blunt
is exotic to the rookies.
Me too.
Yeah. Same game, different level, few lanes. Stay the same, get money.
I have a special guest with me. You want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, it's Solventless Princess.
It's Solventless Princess.
We're here just smoking some blunts today.
Yeah. It's been a good day today.
It has been a good day.
Mm-hmm.
Minus the traffic.
That LA traffic. It's always fun in LA traffic.
Every day's a good day.
Just smoke.
To be alive.
Smoke. Might as well smoke again. Fucking stuck in traffic for 8 hours.
For real. There's nothing else to do in traffic than smoke.
So, yeah. Solventless Princess. I'm sorry. I hate to break it to you, but I got a little nickname for you because it's kind of a long name.
Okay, what is it?
You want to hear it?
Yeah, I want to hear your little nickname for me.
I'm going to call you Solvy P. We're going to call you, or Solvy.
P.
I'm going with Solvy.
Solvy P.
Solvy P. Solventless Princess, a.k.a. Solvy P.
S.P.
We got to shorten it up because that's kind of long, you know?
Solvy P makes me sound like a dude or something.
That's even, you know, it's even more ironic. It's good.
What's up, Solvy?
Solvy. That's hot, right?
Yeah, that's chilling.
I like it.
You can call me Solvy if you want.
Sounds like Solvy, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't like that name. So Solvy P, the Solventless Princess. How'd you come up? What's that about the Solventless Princess?
I just like taking rosin dabs.
Okay.
So, and I think I'm a princess, so.
Well.
A little bit of both. Put them together.
That explains that.
It's like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Makes a lot of sense. Princess.
Rolling up that swisher.
You know what?
I was ready.
You came ready?
Prepared.
All right. I'm not ready yet. I'm rolling up my swisher. Which is fast. I don't know, it's fast and just to the point, you know. Those things take fucking 8 hours to roll.
Doesn't take me 8 hours to roll them. Mm-hmm. Come on now.
That's what we got, man. Rest in peace, Young Dolph, man.
Sure.
Tragedy, what happened. We're gonna listen to a couple of Dolph. Moon rocks. Hey,
pocket full of motherfucking blue guap. Half an ounce in my Gucci two socks. For the summertime, got a new what? Drop. Trapper slash rapper slash bad bitch. Snatcher,
come here.
Baby mama mad. She said you live like a bachelor.
So what?
Sold 100 pounds and gave 10% to the pastor.
Church.
Keep going up the ladder.
Hey.
They mad, make them madder.
Hey.
Told my son when I'm gone, you gon' be a rich little bastard.
Yeah.
Pointers on me hitting. Leave a bitch dizzy. All my old bitches feeling salty. Yeah, yeah. MID, I'm talking about why you doubt me. Yeah, yeah. But I still miss you. Can you call me? Yeah, yeah. I heard that shit changed that you still ballin'.
Adolf,
yeah,
his name,
yeah,
was.
She used to bust them scripts for me at Walgreens. Smuggling narcotics was my calling.
Hey,
Adolf. Hey.
Hold on a Mercedes. That's major. Whole gang going crazy. That's major. Millions on the table.
Where they got that from?
Major. I turned dirt into diamonds. That's major.
You
searching for fame. I became a superstar in the dope game. Found out you a hater, I can't look at you the same. She said, can she take a picture with my chain? Got two twin sisters, call them yin yang.
I wish I wouldn't have fucked that bitch, she insane.
God damn.
Alexander McQueen on me.
Adolph Robert Thornton Jr.
My life ain't never
Young Dog.
Yeah, yeah.
Foes on the Mercedes, that's major.
That's major.
Gang, that's major.
That's major.
Paper route.
Millions on
I fucked
the
dog.
That's major. I turned dirt into diamonds. That's major.
Sometimes in these dudes, guys, it's hard to believe. It's been like, it's been some days, and it's like, dang, is he really dead?
Sad. It's sad so many great artists are passing away like that.
And bitch, we a label. New Glock with a laser.
Yeah,
I let you meet your maker.
Artists dying in their home cities.
With my motherfucking rosters. Yeah, yeah. Moving with my motherfucking shotters. Yeah, yeah.
I feel like he did a lot. Now, I don't know. Not like.
Yeah, yeah.
Somebody said he was like the greatest hustle rapper. The greatest hustle rapper.
Foes on the Mercedes.
No, like, I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know about that, but he definitely like, as far as marijuana in the rap shit, like the hustling and marijuana type shit, he definitely made his mark with that.
Yeah.
His first albums, well, he had Gelato. He kind of made, he was making strings popular. He was taking the strings from out here and making them popular by making music about them. He's pretty dope, man. I like dope.
Fuck yeah. It's a tragedy. It really is.
Mm-hmm. So what's up? What you got right there?
I'm smoking a backwood.
Mm.
And you're gonna smoke what?
I'm finna light the Swisher up.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Swisher.
Swisher, yeah.
For sure.
What do you like about those things? What do you like about them? What's your favorite thing? What do you think when you light that backwood? What do you think your favorite thing about that lighting that backwood is?
My first thought that comes to my mind the moment I light up a backwood is, and this is love. This is love.
That's what love is about?
Yeah. This is literally true love. Nobody, like, smoking a backwood has never done me dirty. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna roll a backwood. The next day, it's still gonna be a backwood.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, never gonna switch up. Always gonna be a backwood.
That's crazy. I have the opposite. When I think of backwood, I think of like, this shit gonna make me dizzy, or it's gonna be unpleasant.
You can't handle. You know what I'm saying? Like a backwood is like, it's a big boy. It's a big boy blunt. Okay.
Hold on.
It's a big boy blunt.
And what does that mean? It's a big boy blunt.
Well,
what does that mean?
Because if you're not rolling like at least 3 G's into a backwood. You're not even rolling a backwood, dude.
All right, so that's what I wanted to talk about, because we were smoking earlier, and what the fuck, you put about at least 5 grams in the fucking backwood.
Yeah.
It was a fat, and I was like, dang, we smoking a lot, and this shit is still trash.
It's still trash.
That's when I was like, you know what,
I'm done
with this,
like,
backwood.
Wait.
You put five G's, stuff that bitch. It was nice. It was a nicely rolled backwood.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying? It didn't make me nauseous or nothing. But you know what? I'm just like, this fat blunt just is not doing it for me.
It's not doing it for you. And so you're going to tell me that rolling a Swisher with like 1 gram, 1.5, is going to do it for you. But smoking, like, I think you're just like delusional at that point. You know what I'm saying? Like,
see, I think it has to do with the airways and shit like that. You feel what I'm saying? Because that
airways.
Shit, yeah, like, it's more of a direct hit. You feel what I'm
like
saying?
Like, in the back like of this, your throat type of shit? Or like,
nah, not like that. But it's, you feel me? This is, like, the airways, you know, like that. Look at that, like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, this is more of a personal,
okay,
direct hit.
Okay, like, so let's stop talking. Okay, let's point the direction, let's point the finger the other way. And, okay, let's talk about some Swishers, right?
All
right. When I smoke a Swisher, I'm thinking this. I'm smoking cardboard. This is a cardboard version of a tobacco leaf. It is ground up and, like, made into, like, paper. Mm. And then you smoke that. But, like, when you smoke it a backwood, at least you get, like, a little bit of, like, natural touch. Because you get that, like, you can
some
see the leaf.
Is
it annoying? You don't get stems in a Swisher for sure, but...
Mm-mm. That's
the beauty about it. That's the beauty about it is, you know, you get lucky. It's a beautiful thing.
I don't have an argument for that. That was interesting. You know.
That was a good one, yeah.
That was a good one. I don't know if I necessarily agree, but I could see your points behind it. You feel what I'm saying?
Well, it's just like, I don't know, dude. Like, I understand. I used to smoke Swishers. Mm-hmm. I used to be a Swisher girly or whatever, but I don't know. Like, I had to put on my big boy pants and smoke the big boy backwards.
So when you say, so my Swishers are outdated. That's what you're saying?
I'm not going to say outdated. I don't know. It could also be a lot to do with, like, where you came from when you were younger. Like, where
in my era people, that I'm from.
Because, like, I feel like growing up, like, smoking backwards was more, like hyped up than, like, smoking anything else. But in other places, I feel like people have, like, different normalities. So it's like,
well, I ain't going to lie. I came from that, like, when I was younger, it was, you know, Mac Dre was talking about backwards and shit.
Yeah.
So it's not like I'm not from that era, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mac Dre kind of started the backwards shit, if you think about it. I don't know. I really don't know anybody else who was talking about it.
Do you like Dutches?
I like Dutches, but they kind of do the same shit backwards, dude. Like, they cool, though.
What is the shit that you're talking about?
It, like, I kind of, like, I can't really handle tobacco like that. Like, I can't smoke cigarettes. So, like, I kind of start to hyperventilate type shit. I get nauseous, like, start sweating. Weird shit.
Okay, but that doesn't mean you have to shit on backwards. Look, you're literally wearing a backwards shirt right now.
What?
You're wearing a backwards shirt right now as we speak.
Am I?
And you're backing up Swisher. You know, you can do whatever. I'm not gonna.
You know what? We're gonna talk about this backwards shirt because it's crazy that I wore it. I didn't expect
that we were gonna talk about this.
Cause you know what? I'm gonna be honest too. It's two things. I wanna say two things. Because earlier when I put this shirt on, I kind of was fucking with backwards.
Earlier, you were kind of fucking with backwards. Earlier, but now, earlier. You don't fuck with backwards so much, no. You're going to talk on the podcast
I never fucked with backwards. But I tried to give him a chance. I gave him a chance.
No,
you know what?
Run that back. He said he did this morning, bro. What are you talking about?
Yeah, no. But I smoked it. This is mid-backwood. You feel what I'm saying? This is mid-backwood. I'm like, I'm good off this. You know what? I'm better than this.
Okay.
That's really what I was like.
You're better than
I'm
a
backwards.
I'm
better than this.
But you're not better than a Swisher.
Mm-mm. It's different.
It's different.
But anyways, I'm going to talk about the shirt.
Talk about it. Talk about right, it.
Off
it
top,
says backward.
Off top.
She's rolling a backward. You have a picture of a girl rolling a backward.
See.
It says good vibes.
What does that have to do with anything?
That you're talking shit on backwards and you're wearing a backwards.
That don't mean that I fuck with backwards, though. Because I don't. So, we're going to get back to the shirt. Anyways, this shirt, my mama got me this shirt.
Uh-huh.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So, off top, my mom got me this shirt. That's
okay.
The only reason.
That's okay.
I would not buy the shirt.
That's okay, then. That's totally okay.
I would not buy this shirt.
Can I see the lighter?
Hold on one second.
That's totally okay, then.
I wouldn't, you know what I mean?
Yeah. That's
my
okay.
Mom bought me a shirt. I'm like, okay, mom, that's cool. You feel me? I'm going to wear the shirt that you bought me. You know what I mean? And then long behold, you know, also I saw it today and I was like, you know what? I kind of fuck with backwards. You fuck with backwards. You know, I was smoking backwards. I was smoking backwards because of you for a second. You know what I mean? And it was like, you know what? This shit is not for me. I really just wasn't getting high.
For sure.
You know what I wanted to do though for us?
What?
I wanted to look up the top 10 the worst things about backwards.
Dude, what the? Dude, then
I just
want
to see.
What
I just
want
to
see.
You're
going to fucking start citing evidence right now?
I just want to see if people feel like I feel. That's all.
Dude, bet someone totally feels the way you feel.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't. So. You're probably right. There's probably fucking... Dude, there's, like, songs that I've listened to that are, like... Fuck a backwoods, Swishers, what I smoke, boy. I'm pretty sure it's Suicide Boys.
Yeah.
But know.
See, those dudes, I'm going to be honest. When I go to the South, them dudes be smoking all kinds of crazy shit. They have, like, fucking the game.
Don't they have, like, white owls and stuff like that?
Game? They got, they got some shit called game. Yeah, no, I don't know, man. I can't smoke too much shit. I just don't get high if I'm not smoking out of a Swisher, really.
I don't know. I don't know what to say. I just don't.
10 shocking facts you didn't know about your backwoods. Oh, hold on. They said Swishers.
Yeah, they're sprayed with chemicals. I know that they're fucking sprayed with chemicals. And they're, like, really bad for you. But isn't all tobacco products bad for you? So that one's automatically crossed out, ruled out.
One, whoa. It says weed and tobacco doesn't mix. I'm pretty sure it does. All right, that's not a good site right there.
I'm pretty sure it does.
It does, right?
Dude.
Let's mix it right now.
That's the only way.
You like joints? I don't like joints.
If they're good joints, if the weed is boof, then it's gonna be a bad joint. Cause, like, it hurts and it's like it roaches your throat super bad. Hmm. But that's so, just what I think.
Let's talk about your introduction. Your introduction to, like, marijuana and stuff.
I think the first time I smoked weed was with one of my homegirls that I played basketball with and another one of my homegirls, and they, like, pretty much peer pressured me to do it, but I think it was for the best reasons, you know?
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Listen, but I want to know about, what do you mean those are the best reasons?
Huh. I don't know, like, I don't know. I mean, I'm happier that I didn't, like stay away from it, I guess.
Hmm.
I mean, other people might be like, oh my God, like, what the fuck? But personally, I don't know. I met a lot of people through it. I've had a lot of interesting experiences because of it, and I wouldn't want to replace those experiences with, like, I don't know, doing something else, like playing sports. Because I was playing sports, but I was like, nah, too much.
What was too much? You wanted to hang out?
Yeah, I just wanted to chill.
That's cool. When did you get the name Solventless Princess? When did you adopt that name? Like, that recent, or is that, like...
No. I was gonna, like, start a Twitch, but then I didn't, because I catted on it. Pretty much.
And you just wanna just go crazy with the game and shit?
Yeah.
What game?
I don't know. Honestly, I was on a really big chess phase for a second.
Yeah?
I was playing lots of chess. I know. So uninteresting, but...
I thought you were going to say Fortnite for real. I'm not going to lie.
Nah. Definitely not. Definitely not one of the games I would play.
I really thought you were going to say Fortnite.
I would probably play, like, horror games.
Okay.
Because, like, there's some good ones.
Yeah, so chess, were you, like, good at all?
At playing video games?
At chess.
Oh, at chess? Yeah. I took chess classes.
Yeah? Oh. Dang, that's interesting.
I know. I'm pretty good. I mean, like, I'm not the greatest, but I like chess because, like, when you play chess with someone, you can, like, hella tell, like, what kind of person they are just by, like, how they move their pieces.
Yeah.
Straight up. Or, like, at least how they're playing. But most people don't think that deep into it.
So that makes me think that you read people. You're sitting there reading your opponent.
Well, it's like in every sport you have to, like...
Yeah, I guess so.
That's not just in chess.
That's, like, more intense, though, I feel like.
What do you mean?
Because, like, chess is one and one, and it's like you're across from each other. It's like, damn, like... What else is there to look at, really? Besides the person across from me, you know what I mean?
I don't know. I mean, I guess, but, like, Like, what about, like, in Battleship? Like, you gotta guess where their, like, shit is, you know, so you can sink it. So it's like you're doing that one-to-one. I don't know.
See, Battleship is fun, though. not like chess isn't fun, but the idea of Battleship is like, you feel me, like, you could be more loose with it. I don't know. It's less serious. Maybe that's what I was trying to say.
Yeah, I guess you're right. It's not that deep.
It's less serious, so it's like, I don't know. I feel chess, you gotta be straight face, you know what I mean? A mean face. You gotta pick a face.
Poker face?
A poker face. Yeah. Poker face. Yeah. I'd pick a mean face. Just.
You gotta dog them. You gotta dog them.
You know what I mean? Straight like up. A dog a little bit. That's cool.
I like playing pool. I think playing pool is fun too.
Like pool at the bar type shit?
Yeah.
Like you're a pool shark?
Yeah, some shit like that, yeah.
Did you take classes on that?
No. Oh. I just like playing that shit.
Mm.
Sometimes.
Okay, so I suck at pool.
Really?
Yeah, I suck at pool and I suck at bowling.
Dude, I remember this one time when I was younger. This is why I like kind of started playing pool, is because I was at like the Boys and Girls Club, right? For summer, right? And like there was a pool, a table there, and everyone was playing pool, and there was like a bunch of older people with like older kids, and like we were playing, and they were like, "You want to play?" And they were like, hit the eight ball. And I was like, nah, something's up with this. Like, they're not just gonna tell me to hit the eight ball.
Something ain't right.
That. For real. So that's when I had my first introduction with a pool table.
Ever since then, it was on.
Mm-hmm.
Dang.
For sure.
So you call your shots and everything?
Yeah. I mean, I could. But I'm not that great. I'm not like amazing, like trick shots and shit like that. But like, I think I'm better than like, pretty average probably.
Alright, I have a question for you, okay. Because you said that your basketball friends introduced you to weed.
Okay.
So when was that? Like in high school?
It was like middle school going into high school summer.
Okay. Yeah, I guess I started smoking that, yeah. This is my question. So did you play sports like a lot?
I was like, dude, I did like sports and I did like fucking extracurricular shit. And like, yeah.
Did you do these things high?
Dude, so no. So I started smoking and I remember one basketball game I smoked before. Mm-hmm. And we were like sitting in like the back room and like, we were like talking about what we were gonna do. And like, I remember sitting there and I was like, bro, I am high as fuck.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know. Like, I'm not taking any of this in. Like, I have mm-hmm. no idea where I am. Like, and then that game, I like went up for a layup and I like giggled the whole way. I was giggling while I was doing a layup and I missed it. I airballed it just to put the cherry on the cake.
Whoa. So you looked high. Yep. You did some high shit and you looked hella high.
Yep. It was bad.
Mm.
It was bad because I was also starting that game too. Just the worst.
Were you like captain? You were captain?
No, I was not captain. I was not that great, honestly. I was only good defensively. That's the only reason why I was on the basketball team.
So, I started getting high kind of young. But I guess I didn't. It was funny because, yeah, some shit, like, I was like, nah, I can't do that. Like, I wouldn't get high and go. So I remember there was two times, like, first of all, I played football. And like I didn't go to my games high until my senior year. My senior year came and I was like, man, I'm gonna try. And I fucking started balling. I played better actually.
Really?
But so I've never played. I would never get high and like go to my games until senior year. And I think I had to go to church a lot. It was like my punishment because I would get in trouble a lot. And I hated church. So they'd make me go to church. And I never get high before I would go to church. And one time, I got high before church. And it was, like, weird. It was the weirdest shit. Yeah, man. Let's go. Speaking about church, since we're talking church, can you play Preach by Young Duff? This is the first song I really was like, okay, I like this dude, man. This dude's pretty dope. I fuck with him. So yeah.
Hood, rich,
yeah.
I don't fuck with these niggas cause they shady. These bitches, they just wanna have my baby. Born in the 80s, crack baby. Mama, she was in the street, so guess who raised me? You motherfucking right, couldn't get it from my mama, so I got it off the block. Been working my whole life, but I ain't never punched a clock. 9 years old, I seen a nigga get shot. Damn. Niggas quick to run they mouth when they get jammed. Pussy ass nigga, tell it on his own fam. The same nigga that you break your neck for.
Let's look up some more Young Duff shit.
Same nigga that cross you out and wet you
more Duff facts.
Supposed to be chasing
playing.
Money, but you chasing bitches. Real bosses don't talk, we just sit back and listen. Stack that paper up and then make boss moves. Yeah. She like to argue, so I sent that bitch to law school.
Your dog, no matter what.
Preach. Same bitch decline, she love you, she'll set you up. Preach.
Out here in these streets, it ain't no such thing as love.
Preach. The only thing I trust is this pistol and these slugs.
Preach. Real nigga shit, only when I do speak.
If that nigga don't work, he'll fucking leave.
Preach. I ain't got shit for a nigga, ain't nothing in this motherfucking world free.
Preach. Zay got the motherfucking bass thumping.
Zay!
Y'all got the motherfucking trap jumping. Doors to the trap open, now I'll sell you something. Hell nah, don't ask, I ain't fronting nothing.
Hell nah.
I fucked your bitch and told her I'll see you around. Dog just skipped town with 200,000. Dog just pulled an 8 in a 2-liter pop. They say Dolph addicted to these streets just like his pops. Addicted to hustling, I can't stop.
Can't stop.
Won't stop.
Won't stop.
Can't stop.
Okay.
Never hear me complain about what I ain't got.
I'm gonna talk to you about something, cause this shit is amazing to me. Did you see about the Amazon dude, the Amazon exec?
What happened?
This dude's in India, and he's being accused of like running like a smuggling operation of like marijuana and weed type shit through like the Amazon shit.
Damn. He's like packing up packs and Amazon boxes and
is
shit.
That not crazy?
That would be a hella. That's a good ass cover though. Like,
I mean, is that not the best cover?
Yeah. Honestly,
I don't know. That shit's crazy to me. Just like,
cause you could have vans just driving around and just be like,
who's gonna question
like,
that?
Yeah, for real.
You feel
like,
what
why
I'm
you got
saying?
So many
like,
boxes in the back, you know? Like,
I don't know. Like, I just feel like something like that, his access had to be like almost limitless. You know what I mean? Like, they probably imagine like the stuff like Amazon could have happen, and it's like they probably don't get, you know, questioned about anything.
They're real.
You know what I mean?
Jeff Bezos and shit.
I don't know.
Dude, Jeff Bezos is like, I don't know, dude. Did you see what happened with like, he posted that shit about Leonardo DiCaprio, and then his like stocks went down, like, cause he posted like, he like threatened him pretty much on Twitter.
Oh, what did he say?
It was like a picture of
I saw
like
the
him.
Picture. You I saw the picture? Picture thing. I saw the picture thing.
Yeah, I posted it on my Instagram. But like, he was like, Leonardo, I mean, Leo, I want to show you something. Because like, Leo was hella like flirting. Mm-hmm. Or not Leo. Yeah, Leo was hella flirting with his bitch. But like, his bitch was hella like.
She's feeling it.
Like, yeah, like.
I mean, come on, that's Leo.
Whatever. I mean, yeah. And everyone's like, oh, it's because fucking Leonardo's fucking 6 foot. And Jeff is like. I think 5'8" or something like that. And Jeff Bezos, crazy.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I don't know, like, you know, like, Mark, you know, it's, have you seen, like, Mark Zuckerberg's fucking advertisements for the metaverse? Like, his advertisements that he's in?
I haven't really seen it, But it's when you said it, I get like a idea, like a almost robot looking.
Dude, it's so funny. I don't know. It's like crazy. Like, do you think the metaverse? Do you think it's really gonna work? Do you think it's gonna work?
I think it is. I think it. You know. Yeah, for sure, it's gonna work.
I think it's gonna work, but I think that it's. Facebook is like the least credible organization or company to do that.
But they have the most power though. You know what I mean?
Does Facebook, dude? But like Facebook is like not like they have so many security issues and like they sell all of their information. Like they have
yeah.
Do you really think that like Facebook is gonna be the company that's gonna do
it? I'm not saying like they're the safest or they're the best, or you know what I mean.
Personally, I think that like Facebook is like getting old and like he's trying to like switch it up.
Oh yeah.
Try something different or whatever.
Yeah. For sure.
You know, I would feel like I feel like a company that would actually be producing or like making the VR headsets would be the companies to do that.
Yeah. Not like well, he teamed up with the Oculus, right?
He teamed up with Oculus?
I think so, right?
No, he did.
That's hard.
Dude, he did.
The Oculus shit is hard. That's hard. So it's like, I don't know, you know?
That's terrible.
Big people are going to team up, and then they're going to make shit even bigger. You know what I mean? So it's like...
I don't know, dude. It's fucking... I don't know. Like, I don't know if I could ever, like, live in virtual reality, like, too much. Like, I'd rather, like, go outside.
Yeah. I think that's going to be the kicker. You got to go, like, for how easy it's going to be to live, like, in that world, you have to, like, be like, okay, I still have to fucking be real life. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's so crazy that that's, like, what's going on right now. It's some straight, like, dystopia shit. Like,
yeah.
Straight dystopia.
It's not like it's new. Like, it's
definitely not new, but now it's getting, like, pushed forward into like putting money into it, like people actually buying things and selling things on there to make money on it.
Yeah,
like that's what they're kind of pushing. It's like people to spend money to buy these like items that you can have virtually, but it's like I don't know.
Anything to make you stay home. If you have it, you're like, fuck, I have it. It's like you know what I mean, psychologically, fuck, I have it.
Straight up,
it's mine.
COVID is so crazy. Yeah. COVID pushed everybody inside. It's so crazy.
I saw somebody said that they were sick off COVID. I'm like, damn, like, I don't know. I don't hear it as much as I used to. But I'm like, dang, like, how do you know? Like, it's COVID, you know? Like, I don't know. It was just like, I don't know.
I just think it's so crazy how everything is now, like, getting pushed so heavily on technology now because COVID... Like, now everything's online. Like, school went all online. Like, that's crazy. Like, everyone was forced to do it online. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was, like, it could be a good thing or a bad thing. Like, people benefit from it. But, like, I don't know. It's just crazy. Because, like, everything is going to, like, digital.
So, what are you saying? What do you think about that? What are you saying?
I just think that it's crazy.
Like, that was the push for that?
Yeah, like COVID put everybody, like, dude, they were doing like court on Zoom. You know what I'm saying? Like, have you seen Drake Bell's Zoom court case?
Oh, yeah.
But, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that kind of stuff.
I feel like it's just like, it's the evolution. You know what I mean? Like, it was bound to happen. You know, everything, I don't know, maybe it was, you know.
No, you're totally right. We're probably going to go to Mars. Like,
yeah,
that's like what everybody's trying to do or whatever. Like, that's so crazy. I don't think that'll happen in our lifetime, but I'm sure it's coming.
It might
maybe.
Yeah, but yeah, I think it's all, I don't know, it sucks sometimes. Shit sucks, but it's like, shit, the virtual, like, you know, like a lot of how a lot of jobs went online type shit. Like, I don't know, a lot of that shit was for the better.
That's, you know? True, because it's, like, less labor, honestly.
Yeah, it's just more convenient, people being able to work from home.
Yeah, but it's also a good thing because it also saves a lot of paper. Like, we're saving a lot of paper by doing everything online.
Yeah.
And, like, taking e-books and shit like that instead of printing books.
Can you play Penguin? Hangman by Young Dog. Hey, I forgot to tell y'all, we are sponsored by Zaza Frenchies, World Life Music Collective. Shout out to Hayes Radio. Hey,
get a nigga froze.
Zaza shit only. Follow us on Instagram.
Yellow diamonds on me, but every
shit only.
Couple rappers do not like me cause I put they hoe. Yo, chicken on.
Shout out to Salvi P.
Something that I don't know. No, 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 no. How to do. It's a big difference way between me and you. I can show you how to hustle, how to ball and how to shoot. Yeah, I can show you how to hustle, how to ball and how to shoot. I've been doing this since a jit, little bitch. This shit ain't nothing new. No, new, 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 new. Money coming in, bitch, I like my shit in all blue. I'm about to buy another truck and finna give away my coupe. I'm shooting shit like Paul Pierce, bitch, I ball, yeah, I'm the truth. I just post some walk hard up in my Mountain Dew. I be shitting on these niggas, that's all that I do. I be shitting on these niggas, that's all that I do. I be shitting on all these niggas, that's all that I do. I be shitting on all these niggas, that's all that I do. I be shitting on all these niggas, that's all that I do.
Yeah.
Oh, then how you?
Dang, man. That's crazy. Do you follow the blacklist people on Instagram?
No, I don't think so.
You know what I'm talking about?
I don't think so.
Dang, it's crazy. They must be like shadow banned because it's hard to
shadow banned.
It's hard to find them.
I got perma banned.
Oh, there we go, right there. Yeah, these dudes right here.
No, what is it?
They just have like a lot of the like news and shit going on.
The moves.
News.
Oh, news.
Is that what it sounded like I said?
Yeah. I thought you said got a lot of moves and shit.
Nah, my bad. If I sound really high, it's because I'm really fucking high right now. And yeah. I start fucking talking slow, lazy type shit.
For real, I get hella quiet sometimes. Like, sometimes I talk really, like, hella quiet. And shit like that, you know?
You didn't even smoke your backwood.
But...
Give must not be break, that good. Dude.
Oh my god.
I'm just saying.
Because you're smoking what? A gram? You're smoking it 1 gram?
I smoked
gram?
My shit though.
Oh my god.
Your shit must not be that good.
You didn't even finish the other backup with me.
Nah, I couldn't.
I just don't get it. Like, how could you say that, like, this is, like, weak compared to yours and it literally has more weed in it? It just doesn't make sense. Like,
sometimes less is
like,
more.
Mathematically?
Sometimes less is more. That's like saying, like, you know, taking a snapper, like, you feel what I'm saying? Like, a bong rip, you know? Sometimes you just take the right amount of that.
Do you like taking bong rips? Personally, I don't really like taking bong rips anymore.
No?
I used to, but I'm not really anymore.
I never did. I never did.
I don't really like...
You know what? I can't have a buddy. He tries it. He gets all the crazy rosin. He gets crazy rising. He usually has, like, I really like smelling, like, the GMO type shit. I feel like GMO and, like, rising is, like, the craziest smelling shit. But he always tries to get me to take a dab. I'm like, hell no. I can't do it.
Why not?
Because I cough. Every time I'll do it, I'll be like, all right, I'm going to do it.
I know, but when you... That's, like, the part, like, no, that's the best part.
It's a too, different...
Like, it gets you super fucking high.
I get a different type of cough, though.
It hurts, yeah. It comes from, like, within you. It's not from, like, the back of your throat. It's
and
like,
I can't stop, though.
I know, but that's the point of taking fucking concentrates.
I don't think so. If that's the point, then I don't want it. You feel what I'm saying? If I have to take a dab... And lose my fucking lung and then never want to fucking smoke again in my fucking life, then I don't want to do it.
For sure.
You know what I mean? I don't know. That's just how I feel.
Well, dude, there's like terp slurpers now.
What's that?
Dude, terp slurpers? Like, it's like a different nail. and you slurp. It's like crazy.
What do you
and that
do?
That shit like gets you so fucking high. Like that shit gets you so high to the face, like to your brain.
What do you do? What do you mean? What, a different type of now?
Like people that know, if you know, you know. If you know, you know. People that know, you know.
You know what
it's
I
like
I,
to take a slurper.
I don't know. Obviously, I don't know.
How I describe a slurper is like you're taking like a bong rip dab.
Okay.
It's crazy.
Okay.
You know what
so,
I'm talking about? Terp slurper? No.
I don't know. I did. I hit this thing over the weekend. It was a fucking. It was weird. It was a little like rubber thing. You feel what I'm saying? It was a little rubber thing, and it had a cart attached to it. And he put it on the fucking on the rig.
Oh.
You seen one of those?
So it was like a wax pen hit through a bong.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh. Yes. I mean, yeah.
How you feel about that?
I mean, like, that's cool. I get that's pretty cool. Like, taking a fat ass hit from, like, a pen is pretty cool. But I feel like when you're taking a dab, it's just different. I think when you smoke wax pens, it doesn't, like, get you all the way high.
Right? I'm like, I get it, bro. I don't know. He was hella juiced. I'm like, okay, it's cool, dog. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, it's kind of creative, I guess.
Yeah.
But I hit it, and I'm just like, this just fucking whatever distillate, I guess. It's just, I don't know, just the whack shit. Whatever the fuck they
maybe
put
it
in.
If it was, like, live rosin.
It might, you might as well. I was just like, I'd rather fucking take a fucking dab, bro.
Shut up.
You know, so, I don't know. What'd you call that thing again? The nail, the what?
It was a terp slurper.
Terp slurper. Is that, like, the actual name?
Yeah, like, I think, I don't know who made it, but, like, I know Bear Quartz is, like, fucking crazy about that shit. Like, they're posting how the terp slurpers. But, yeah, you just, it pretty much, like, I don't know, it, like, sucks up all the wax and, like, you smoke all of the wax. Like, it doesn't, you don't, like, put like, a top part on it. You just, like, slurp it through. I don't know. It's crazy. I'm probably not describing it very well, but I'm also really high, so.
This sounds very interesting. I'm not gonna lie.
But it is really interesting. It's crazy.
I have a question for you. We're about to wrap it up. But I have a question.
What?
Where's your favorite place to smoke?
My favorite place to smoke? Honestly, I like smoking, like, inside.
Yeah.
I just like smoking inside so much more than smoking outside. Like, I know that's really general, but, like, it's just, like, I don't know. So much better. There's no wind to, like, put it out so fucking fast.
That's interesting. I'm like that. Since I remember being young and I was like that. And I was like, man, for sure. Like, off top, I don't want to fucking get high off outside. Like, I just feel like... I feel like certain shit limits my, like, ability to get high, you know?
Yeah.
It might be a mind thing, like, that's why I don't really smoke joints.
I really like smoking in, like, my bed.
In the bed?
Yeah, and then, like, going to sleep.
I don't know. Definitely inside. I don't know about in the bed. Like, I don't know.
You gotta be careful sometimes with the ash, but...
I guess I don't really smoke to, like... I don't know, I smoke, but not really like, okay, I'm gonna smoke and then pass out type shit.
I smoke to sleep, that's why. I smoke so I can sleep. I just insomnia.
Smoke. I just smoke and I smoke. I wake up and smoke and then be like, man, I smoke. Then we smoke again. Some days I don't really smoke, though. Sometimes I feel like people just think I'm like...
Some days I don't smoke, but I really need it to sleep, like... I take, like, edibles to go to sleep.
Yeah. I fuck with edibles to go to sleep.
Me too.
I like
them. Like, good-ass drinks sometimes. I've tried some drinks. They're kind of fire. But, like, yeah, there's some good-ass edibles. Some solventless edibles.
Solventless edibles.
Straight up.
You finna start lying, huh? You finna go crazy with it. Do you want to give out your Instagram or anything?
No.
Okay, cool.
I'm just mysterious like that.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Are you going to come back?
I don't know, maybe. We'll see.
I want to do one and have like two more people here.
Okay.
Like four people. You know what I mean?
Who?
I don't know.
Me asking right now.
But I'm like, yeah. I know exactly who it's going to be. I'm not going to tell you, though.
Okay. You don't have to tell me.
But yeah, no. And put it together. Why, you don't want to come if other people are going to be here?
It just depends. I don't know.
Why, are you too mysterious?
I'm so mysterious.
Oh, man.
I'm like, very mysterious.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Mm. Well, I have to talk about our sponsors. Zaza Frenchies on Instagram, Zaza_Frenchies. Oh, that's what too. I'm gonna actually have somebody on the next show. This guy, this breeder, is gonna be coming on. So that should be cool. So yeah, I'm gonna have him, and then that show. I want a dog breeder, and then I want like some type of stoner. Yeah, sounds like a plan. Shout out to Haze Radio. I didn't say Haze Media. Haze Radio. It's motherfucking. It's fucking time to smoke. I'm not gonna lie, I wish I had one more swisher.
I don't know what to tell you.
See, you didn't smoke your backwards yet.
You're the one wearing a backwards shirt, okay? I don't wanna hear it. If you like it so much, you're gonna wear a shirt for it. You can smoke the rest of my backwards.
Put my jacket back on.
Yeah, put that jacket back on.
Hide this motherfucking.
Hide that shirt. I'm gonna make you regret wearing that shirt today for sure.
It's already over.
It's already over.
The shirt's over. The shirt's over. The day's over.
This never is gonna over, see.
You're
sure.
Never gonna see this shirt again.
You're listening to Haze Radio Network. Cannabis Lifestyle Radio.